Now this part of mathematics that is named as Vedic mathematics. Few topics of Vedic mathematics are very helpful for you if you want to calculate in short term. We say shortcut processes of calculation. The first topic is squaring of numbers ending with 5. Squaring, you know, squaring of number, square of A, that is A into A equal to A square. Squaring of 2 into 2 equal to 4. Squaring of 12 into 12 equal to 144. Means in the square of any number we multiply the same number twice to get the square of that number. Here a special type of number that is ended with 5. How will you get the square of that number in short way? Suppose a square of 65. In this number of 65, the number is ended with 5. This is mandatory, this is compulsion of this rule, that number should be ended with 5. We can get the square of that number in shortcut. You know, for that simple process is we multiply 65 and 65 twice. This simple process that I am writing here, I am solving this square of 65 through simple process. 5 5s are 25, in hand 2, 5 6 are 30 and 2, 32, 6 5s are 30, in hand 3, 6 6 are 36 and 3, 39. So the answer became 5, 2, 12 and 4. This is the simple way or general way. Simple method or general method. But Vedic mathematics provides us a shortcut way. If the number is ended with 5, then the multiplication will be 5 5s are 25. I wrote 5 5s are 25 and one number, that is the remaining part of the number, one number you increase by 1. If you increase by 1 this number 6, then that new number will be 7. And now you multiply these two, 7 6 is 42, 4 2 2 5, 4 2 2 5. We take the another examples. Those are 75 into 75. In the square you multiply twice, so I multiplied the 75 twice to get the square of 75. As per the rule, 5 5s are 25. You increase the 7 by 1, you are getting 8. And you multiply these two, 7 8 are 56. Next example, 105 into 105. It means we are going to find the square of 105. So 5 5s are 25. You increase this 10 by 1, you are getting new number 11. And now you multiply this 10 and this 11, you are getting 110. means 105 into 105 equal to 11025. But this is the compulsion that numbers should be ended with 5. We can calculate, we can get the square through this shortcut process. Second topic, multiplication of numbers whose last digits add to 10 and the remaining digits are the same. First of all, you have to identify the numbers, which kind of number you can multiply applying this topic. So those numbers, 66 into 64. Another example, 107 into 103. One more, 91 into 99. These three examples I have selected to explain this process. As per the rule, multiplication of numbers whose last digit add to 10. These two are the last digits of these two numbers. Addition of this last, these two are 6 and 4 are the last digits of these two numbers, 66 and 64. And addition of these two, 6 and 4 is equal to 10. You come to this, last digits of these two numbers are 7 and 3. Addition of this 7 and 3 is also equal to 10. Come to this example. Last digits are 1 and 9. The sum of these two last digits is equal to 10. First compulsion. Second compulsion is the remaining part. The remaining part of the number should be the same. The remaining digits should be the same. Here is 6, here is 6. Here is 10, here is also 10. Here is 9, here is also 9. These two are the compulsions. I repeat these two compulsions. Addition of last two digits of two different numbers should be equal to 10. 6 plus 4, 10, 7 plus 3, 10, 9, 1 plus 9, 10. Add the remaining, second compulsion, add the remaining part of those numbers should be same. Such as the remaining part of 66 is 6, and remaining part of 64 is 6. These two are same. Here, remaining part of 107 is 10, remaining part of 103 is 10. These two are same. Similarly, here also, remaining part of 91 is 9, remaining part of 99 is 9. These two are also same. So, for this type of multiplication of two different numbers, we will apply the process of topic 1. As we had applied the process in topic 1, the same process will apply in topic 2 to multiply these two different kinds of number whose the sum of last two digits is equal to 10 and the remaining part, remaining digits of those two different numbers are same. So for that, we multiply 64 is 24 and you increase this number by 1. So new number you get 7. Now you multiply 6 and 7, you are getting 42. In these two numbers, the addition of these two 7 and 3 is being 10. And the last digit, remaining digits are same, 10 and 10. So you increase this 10 by 1, you are getting new number 11. Now you multiply this 10 and 11, you are getting 110. So say 3 7s are 21 and this 110. The multiplication of 107 and 110 became 11,021. One more, a different kind of example is this. We are getting 91 and 99. The sum of these two digits is being 10, and the remaining part of the numbers, remaining digits of the numbers are same, 9 and 9. So we multiply this 1 and 9, we are getting 9. But always you write this multiplication in two digits. You must keep one zero. This is different, a little different. As we are multiplying, I repeat, as you multiply 9 and 1, we got 9. But you write this multiplications in two digits, 0, 9. Now, you increase this number by 1, you are getting 10. Now you multiply 9 and 10, you are getting 90. So this multiplication became 9009. I taught two topics today. I hope these two topics will be very helpful to calculate in short way, in shortcut. And it's very important to save time in calculation of mathematics. So, as these topics are applicable in your calculation, you must apply to verify the processes. As you apply, then this will remain in your memory for a long time. Thank you. I shall try to teach more topics tomorrow, especially for the lower classes such as class 6, 7, 8 and 9. For these four classes, this type of processes are very important to calculate in shortcut.